So this is the data warehouse architecture. It is very easy to understand the data warehouse architecture here. We'll start, as I discussed earlier, we are having operational systems. So whatever systems which are currently in use, okay, they are operational systems. Now, operational systems are generating the different data in different way. Either we are acquiring the data from the external sources, or the operational system may generate the data through some IoT devices or some other way by making the data entry operations, as we discussed in a previous lecture. Okay. Now, that means operational system generates the data, and those data are available into the transaction databases. As you can see here, the transaction databases. These are the transaction databases. Okay. So currently, the data are available or generated into the operational system are stored into the transactional databases as per the transactional database schemas. Now, we are also having external data. Some external resources are there by which we can also acquire the data into the transactional databases. There is one ETL tool. ETL stands for Extract, Transform, and Load. So ETL tools perform three operations: extraction of the data from the transactional and external data sources, transform those particular data in some useful form. It means like we will perform some pre-processing task with the transactional databases, because as in the previous lecture I explained, the data are not in, they are not fully of high quality data. Like we need to remove some noisy data. We need to fill some unavailable data, like the data with null value. We need to be replaced by some suitable value, and so on. So transform is that kind of processes, and then after load operation, we load those data into the data warehouse. So by saying the size of the transactional databases and the size of the data warehouse, you can easily understand. Obviously, the size of data warehouse is very larger than the transactional databases. Then we can perform the different query operations using the query tools from the data warehouse, and we can extract the data for the data mart. Now, this is very important word, data mart. Data mart is nothing but a data warehouse of any individual department. Remember one thing, an enterprise having multiple departments, and the data for individual department which we are storing into the data warehouse are the data mart. Now, the collection of the data of different data marts will form a data warehouse for the enterprise. There is one analytic application. Whatever applications that you are using for analysis purpose, they are fetching the data from the data mart. Okay, and see, you can also see one metadata entity which is related with the data warehouse, centrally data warehouse. Then we are having the last component, that is reporting, analysis, and mining tools. As I discussed in a previous lecture, data warehouse is useful for reporting purpose, analysis purpose, and some mining operations. Okay, so like here you can see the presentation will be in some usable form, or we can say the presentation will be so the presentation is nothing but we are representing the reports or the analysis results, or we can say the knowledge generated by different mining tools and different techniques or methods in some pictorial form, such that the decision makers can take the proper decisions. Okay, the reports can be interactive report, it can be ad hoc report, or it can be static record. So this is the overall architecture of data warehouse. Okay, so I hope you all understand the architecture of data warehouse.